In this class, we are discussing few more problems based on basic concept of probability and with the help of addition and multiplication theorem. First, you read out the problem. The problem is from 6 positive and 8 negative numbers, 4 numbers are chosen at random and multiplied. What is the probability that the product is a positive number? Now, totally how many numbers you have? 14. Either may be positive, may be negative. Totally how many numbers you have? 14 numbers, 6 plus 8. But randomly, it means you are not worried about whether we are selecting positive, negative. Randomly, they are going to pick or selecting 4 numbers. After that, once you multiply that, what is the probability that the product is a positive number? Suppose you multiply 4 numbers, the product should be a positive. Such type of cases we are going to take. What is the probability for that? Now, totally we are selecting at a time. How many numbers? 4 numbers. But not only selecting 4 numbers, but product must be a positive number. What are the possibility? Either I am selecting all 4 numbers are positive or 4 numbers are negative. One possibility is 2 positive numbers and other 1 negative, because product of 2 negative numbers must be positive. Then these 2 are positive, we get positive number. Except these 3 cases, you can't expect in any other cases the product must be a positive. Not only selecting 4 numbers randomly, the product should be positive. Therefore, what I'm going to do here, instead of carrying the statement to write in each of the case, I'm going to assign the what are the possible cases product of 4 numbers must be positive. I'm assigning each of the cases to one alphabet. Now, therefore, A is what choosing 4 positive numbers, and B is a 4 negative numbers, C is choosing 2 positive and 2 negative numbers. You can't expecting except these 3 cases. Therefore, what we are going to do in the next step is, now, I want to find out the probability of this. Now, first you have to write what is my exhaustive case. Exhaustive case for this problem. Exhaustive cases is nothing but 6 plus 8 is nothing but 14. But we are selecting at a time how many exhaustive cases are selecting at a time of 4. Therefore, what is a total exhaustive cases is 14 C4 is my exhaustive cases. I think it's clear, because whenever I'm going to take exhaustive case, first I have to take what is total number of numbers we have. 14. Out of 14, we are selecting at a time how many? 4. Therefore, what's my exhaustive case is 14 C4. The next is, now there are 3 possibilities. What are the 3 possibilities are written? Choosing 4 numbers are positive, maybe negative numbers, or 2 numbers are positive and 2 numbers are negative. Now, if you want to find out probability of 4 numbers are chosen at random and multiplied, what is the probability that the product is a positive number? Now, means we have to find out either the case A happened, or B happened, or C has happened. Suppose choosing 4 positive numbers, at a time you can't expect in the same case, you can't expect to choose 4 negative numbers, and also you can't expect 2 positive and 2 negative numbers. But all 3 cases are given rise to the probability of choosing the 4 numbers multiplied. We get a what number? Positive number. At least one must be happen. Therefore, what we are going to take in between that? Union. Probability of union, union C. But one happen, we can't expect it at a time other two. Means all A, B, C are mutually exclusive. From the addition theorem, this can be written as probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C. Now, from this theorem, addition theorem. AT means addition theorem. Don't write AT in your while writing a solution in the exam. Must and should I try 10 times expansion? What is A, what is T? Since A, B, C are mutually exclusive, Okay? Yeah. Because we can't expecting all ABCs simultaneously happening. Therefore, what's the next step? Now I have to write what's the probability of A, what's the probability of B, what's the probability of C. See, we are picking or choosing, or chosen, or picking, or selecting days above for combination. Most of the students doing a mistake to which one, in which case I'm going to take combination, which case I'm going to go for permutation. Here we are going to select in picking and choosing, therefore go for combination. Now here, totally here, how many negative numbers are there? 6. How many positive numbers are there? 8. Probability of A means that selecting all 8, all 4 numbers are must be positive. Therefore, out of 6 you are selecting how many? 4. This is a favorable number of cases selecting 4 positive numbers out of 6 divided by x as to case 14C4. Okay. Plus, the next is we are selecting all our negative numbers. How many negative numbers are? 8. Out of 8 number you are selecting 4. Divided by x as to case is 14C4. Plus, in this case, at a time, we are selecting 2 positive number. How many positive number? Out of 6, we are selecting 2. At a time, we are selecting 2 negative. Therefore, 8C2. Why I am taking the product? Because both must be happened. Now, here, this happening is depending upon what happened in the positive number. We are selecting 2 positive number at a time and 2 negative numbers divided by x as to case 14C4. You simplify that, finally we get 505 divided by 1001. If you want to write it in the form of decimal, 0.5045. Once you write it in the form of decimal, round up to 4th place. Because we are not writing all what we divide, you get infinite number, you are not written all the numbers. Therefore, whenever I get an answer in the problem, you leave it in the form of fraction only. Okay? Now I think it's clear how to solve this problem. Selecting 4 random numbers, so after you selecting, then you have to take a product what you are expecting, positive number. Instead of positive number, they are going to ask the negative number also. What is the product is negative number. They have to take carefully what are the possibilities. Yeah, 3 negative number, 1 positive number. This one case. Because minus into minus 3 times minus into plus is minus. And then, this is a, so you can't choose 2 positive and 2 negative. Is if we have only one possibility, we get, we suppose product is a negative number. Now I am showing the entire problem in one screenshot. Observe carefully and then try to understand that how to solve such type of problem. Okay? It's not possible I have to solve all the problems on the board. Yeah, I am going to share my e-content notes, you go through it. Okay? Now I move to the next problem. This problem already written the board because then you have to save time consumption here. Okay. Yeah. Next is 3 balls are drawn successively from a box containing 6 red balls, 4 white balls, and 5 blue balls. Find the probability that they are drawn in the order red, white, and blue if each ball is replaced and not replaced. Yeah, such type of problem we have not discussed. Therefore, in this problem we are discussing. Okay, solution. Okay. Yeah, in the solution, observe carefully, 3 balls are drawn successively from a box containing how many red balls? 6 red balls, okay, 4 white balls, and then 5 blue balls. Total, how many balls you have? 15 balls, okay, you remember this part, okay. We are selecting, picking the 5 of our combination, okay. We are, now here, But they are given particular revival. They are not given selecting three balls randomly. We are select, the three balls are drawn successively in order. They are given order. First we are selecting red ball and next selecting white ball and selecting blue ball. Therefore, what I am going to do, before I am going to start the write the solution, now I am going to define different, I am going to assign the different alphabets for choosing a red ball, choosing white ball and blue ball. Yeah, drawing a red ball. Yeah, because they are given order. Drawing a white ball. The next one, drawing blue ball. This order only we have to draw. Three balls. Okay? Yeah. In the next step, find the probability that the drawing three balls successfully without replace. First one is red, second one is white, third one is blue, without replace and with replaced. Okay? Now first I am going to take first solution for the first case. Yeah. Means with the replaced means, once you select red ball, before going to select white ball, we are replacing that red ball. And then, before going to selecting blue ball, we are replacing white ball. Okay? That is called with the replacement. Therefore, the required probability, but all are must be happened. Probability of E1 intersection, E2 intersection, E3, because we are drawing the balls successfully. How many? Three. One is red, white and blue. All must be happen. Intersection. And then selection of red ball is not depending upon white ball, is not depending upon blue ball. Red ball depends on total number of how many red balls you have. White ball depends on totally how many red, white balls and then how many blue balls. They depend there itself. Selection of red ball is not depending upon white ball, it's not depending upon blue ball. Therefore, from the multiplication theorem, now I took right probability of E1 into probability of E2, probability of E3, because all three are independent. All three are independent. Is correct? What I written the board? Now, first you select red and then you have to select white and select and then blue. The selection of E2, first you select E1, then only I select E2, then I have to select E3. Okay. Now, from which theorem? Multiplication theorem. Okay. Now, see, please try to understand. First you select, all three are happen. First you select white ball and then you select red ball. And then you select this. Means, I have to write what condition. What is condition for this? Yeah. Yeah, you please take care for this. You must be right condition for that. All are must be happen, but selection of red one is depend upon first you selection of white one is depends upon first you have to select red one. Therefore, what is the probability here? Probability of E2 / E1. While doing the selection of blue one, you must be selected already. What are the balls? Red and white. Means E1 intersection E2. Yeah. Yeah, that's why I am writing directly what they feel. That's not correct. The selection of these two depends upon what we selected previously. Therefore, now E2, writing a probability of E2, E3 depends upon E1. E1 happened, then only E2 happened. Yeah, happening. E3 happening, only E1 and E2 happened. Even E2 happened, then only E3 happening, because we are selecting blue. Once you selected already red and white, therefore what is the probability of writing E2? E2 / E1 and probability of E3 is E1's intersection E2. Both are happened, then only E3 is happening. Now, what is total number of total number of balls in a box? How many balls you have in the box? 15. Out of 15, exhaustive case, we are selecting at a time, we are selecting, yeah, one after the other. See, three balls are drawn successfully. Successfully means one after the other. Keep in mind. one after the other. If out of 15 balls, we are selecting one ball. Means first red ball. How many red balls you have? 6. Therefore, here, what's a favorable number of cases? Selection of red ball is 81. And then, yes? Now observe, at a time, balls are drawn successfully, one after the other. But we are selecting first red, before selecting white, we are replacing, therefore total must be same, 5, 7. And then how many white balls you have? Out of 4, we are selecting 1. And then, before selecting next blue ball, we are replacing, therefore total must be same. Now, how many blue balls you have? 5, 7. Please try to understand, we are selecting one after the other, successfully means one after the other. Therefore, total must be same in each of the case because before selecting white ball, we are going to replacing it. Therefore, total must be same. Okay. In the next is 6 by 15, 4 by 15 and then 5 by 15. You multiply and then simplify, we get 8 divided by 225 is the answer. Next, move to the second case, not replaced. Not replaced. Second one, again I want to find out probability of E1 intersection, E2 intersection, E3. But the thing is, again the formula must be same, probability of E2 happening means E1 must be happened. E3 happening means both E1 and E2 must be happened. Okay, from the multiplication theorem. But little bit vary in the exhaustive case. We are selecting out of 6 red ball, 1, but what's the total is 15C1. But you are not replacing. You already selected one red ball means in the exhaustive case how many have? 14. We are selecting 1. But how many white ball you have? 4C1. Into them. Now again I have to reduce one because you already keep aside what are the balls? Red and white ball. Therefore what's the remaining? 13 balls. 13C1. How many blue balls you have? Totally how many? 5. 5C1. Then simplify that, we get 6 by 15, 4 by 14, 5 by 13. Simplify that, we get 4 by 91 is the answer. Don't confuse here, we are successfully means we are selecting one after the other. With replacements, exhaustive case must be same. Without replacements, then we are going to reduce while writing exhaustive case for white and white and blue ball. This is where I have to write the answer. Now this is one of the problem how to solve without replacement, with replacement. Therefore I discuss one problem. Refer textbook and refer my e-content notes. There we have without and with replacement few more problems. Okay. Now move to the next problem. I'm showing the entire problem in one screenshot. Observe carefully and then try to understand that. Okay. Now we are moving to the next problem. Yeah. The next problem is find the probability that observe carefully for this. Find the probability that a leap year having, the leap year selected at random will contain 53 Sundays. Observe carefully. This is one of our important problem. Observe carefully and try to answer this. Okay, now we go to the problem. Now observe carefully, leap year means how many days you are in the leap year you are expecting. Everyone will know that in the leap year how many days you have. Yeah. 366 days you have. Okay. In the that is of point, you know that how to proceed, how to do it. Okay. Now here observe carefully and then I have to do the problem. Okay. Now here, in the please go through like two number of times before going to solve the problem. First you go through the problem carefully and try to understand that what they expecting, what they doing in the problem. Okay. Now we are moving to define the probability that a leap year selected at random. Yeah, at random. Will contain 53 Sundays. They given 53 Sundays here. Maybe instead of Sunday 53 Sunday, they may be give 53 on Monday. Any one of the days of the week: Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. In all the case, the way of writing solution must be same. Find the probability that the leap year selected at random will contain 53 Sundays. Will contain 53 Sundays. Instead of Sundays, they may be given Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Okay. Now we know that a leap year contains how many days? 366 days. Leap year contains how many days? 360 days. Okay, in 360 days, but in one week, how many days you have? 7 days. Therefore, divide 366 divided by 7 means 7 366. 7 5s are 35. 1 6 7 2s are 14. The remaining 2 days. See, out of 366 days, completely we get how many weeks? 52 weeks. But they mentioned, it's a leap year, 360 days, you have randomly will contain 53 Sundays. The full clutch, once why I divided by 366 days by 7? Because 1 week have how many days? 7 days. Therefore, I have to divide 366. Therefore, what are the possibility have? How many days are remaining? 2 days are remaining. These 2 days, you know that what are the possibility. The what are the 2 days are selecting? That selection of these 2 days, I'm going to write what are the possibility. The first possibility is Monday, Tuesday. Okay. Second one is Tuesday, Wednesday. Okay. Consecutive days you have to take. You can't pick Monday, Wednesday like that. Okay. Third one, Wednesday, Thursday. Okay. Fourth one, Thursday, Friday. Okay. Fifth one, Friday, Saturday. Sixth one, Saturday, Sunday. Seventh one, Sunday and Monday. But they asking the question is they contain randomly contain how many Sundays? 53 Sundays. Therefore, observe carefully totally how many possibility remaining. The selection of the remaining 2 days are how many possibility? 7 possibility. Yes, therefore favorable number of cases. What is my exhaustive case is 7. Because what we did, that 366 days were divided by 7 because 1 week having 7 days. The remaining days I have written on the board what are the possibility. Now these are the exhaustive case. But they asking they contain how many Sundays? 53 Sundays. Therefore we are selecting favorable number of cases to contain 53 Sundays. So in a leap year, what are the favorable number of cases is 2. Means we are selecting the cases involving Sunday. Therefore, what is the required probability? The required probability is nothing but the required probability is equal to 2 divided by by 7. Favorable cases is nothing but what are the cases having Sundays or the favorable cases, because they given the containing 53 Sundays. Suppose they given 53 Mondays, means I to take favorable cases is for 2. Monday in morning, this and this. In all the cases, we get the same probability only. This again, I have to find out the probability for the given maybe particular Sundays, Monday or Tuesday. Now, I taken a leap year, they may be non-leap year also. Please go through properly the problem and try to understand the problem, and then write what they expecting the problem answer. Okay. I think it's clear how to solve the problem for leap year containing 53 Sundays. Instead of 53 Sundays, maybe in any days from Monday to Sunday, in all the case, the way of approaching must be same. Okay. Now I'll move to the next problem. The next problem is, if all the letters of word engineer, the words of word they given engineer, be written at random, what is the probability that all the letters E are formed together? Here we are doing arrangement. Whenever we are doing arrangement, here we are going to take which one? Permutation. This especially in the permutation part, in the first class of probability explained, under the permutation there are three different formulas. Here we are doing the arrangement. While doing arrangement, how many letters you have in engineer? How many letters you have in engineer? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The word engineer having 8 letters. First you have to know exhaustive case. After that, they asking what is the probability that all the letters E are formed together. Suppose you have to tie up what are the E have in the engineer, what tie up together, then what is the probability tie up together to form the arrangement, what is the probability for that case, they asking. Therefore, first you have to find out the total number of arrangements of the letters involved in the word engineer is n factorial divided by. While writing the formula for this is n factorial divided by n1 factorial, n2 factorial, like that. N1, n2 are nothing but different type of category of letters. E is one category, N is another category, G is another category, like that. Now E is repeated how many times, G is repeated how many times, like that. E is having 3, therefore N means 3 factorial. Next is N is 2 factorial. And then my G is only 1 factorial, and then I is 1 factorial, this is E, this is N, this is G, this is I, and then next is R, is only 1. Each of the different category of letter chooses N1 factorial, N2 factorial and N3 factorial, etc. Now this is nothing but E factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial, because we are going to neglect the 1 factorial because the value of 1 factorial is 1. Next, I want to find out favorable cases. Suppose you for taking all E's together, means tie up together. See, please observe carefully how many E's are there. 3 E's are there in the word engineer. Means 1 E goes, means all other 2 also goes. Means tie up together means treated as 1. Means automatically 1 E moves, means the other 2 also move together. Therefore totally have 3. Okay. Yes, tie up together means treated as 1. Therefore what is the remaining 2? Remaining 2 we are not considered here. Why? Because 1 E moves, automatically other 2 E's are moves. There is no need to count other 2 E's. because we are tying all these together. Whenever I want to find out all these together or tie up together means, first you count how many letters you have the corresponding what you are going to do the tie up for the letter. Here tie up for the letter is E. How many numbers you have? E you have 3. Minus 1. Why I am doing minus 1 means I am treated as 1, as subtract 1. How many are remaining? 2. This remaining 2 I subtract from total number of letters in the word engineer. What we get? 8 minus 2. What we get actually? 6. Yes. Is it clear? I think 6 is a thing you know that how we get 6. Okay. Now, total number of arrangements for the word engineer to getting all is together is 6 factorial, yeah, divided by, because we are neglecting other two. Therefore, now we are treated 6, tie up E is treated as 1. Therefore, there is 1 factorial, 2 factorial for N. And then the rest of thing as 1. Okay. Is nothing but 6 factorial divided by 2 factorial. Please try to understand. In the word engineer, we are tying up all things together and treated as 1. Therefore, subtract 2 from total number of letters in engineer. While writing in the denominator, instead of this, we are 3, we are writing 1 factorial, 2 factorial, 1. Therefore, we get 6 factorial divided by 2 factorial. Therefore, the required probability equals 6 favorable number of cases to selecting the engineer by doing the arrangement, tie up all these together. What is my favorable cases? 6 factorial divided by 2 factorial. Over divided by x has 2 cases, 8 factorial divided by 3 factorial to 2 factorial. Simplify that, finally we need 3 by 28 is the answer. 3 by 28 is the answer. Okay. Now, in the next step, we are going to consider the last problem for the basic concept of problem. I think everyone is clear how to write the solution for the word. Suppose they mention here, they mention engineer, sometimes they are going to give Allahabad like that. Suppose they have given a word Allahabad or engineer, how to find out the probability? Means there we are going to use the, don't use the combination, because we are doing the arrangement. Therefore, don't use the combination. We are not doing the selection, we are doing arrangement. Therefore, while doing arrangement, now we have to go for permutation and to take a decision for the probability. But tie up together means taking together. Now, treated as a serial. Then I explain very carefully, this is the way I have to find out the probability for whenever they mention the any word to find out the probability. You refer textbook, you work no problem. Okay. Next, move to the next last problem. Is A speaks the truth in 75% cases and B is in 80% of the cases. In what percentage of cases are they likely to contradict each other in stating the same fact? This is one of the important problem. Yes, observe carefully. This is one of the important thing. Anyone, A means this particular person, speaks the truth 75% cases and B in 80% of the cases. In what percentage of the cases are they likely to contradict each other in stating the same fact. In same statement, a same statement, they are likely to contradict each other. Means, suppose A speaks the truth, the same statement B speaks the is not speaking the truth, is telling lie. Suppose B speaks the truth, the same fact means same statement. A speaks lie. This is a mean contradict to each other. Therefore, what I am going to do here, instead of writing A speaks the truth, B speaks the truth, I am going to assign E1 is A speaks the truth. And E2 is nothing but B speaks the truth. Okay. Then, what's the probability there? The probability of E1 is nothing but 75%, 75 by 100. Probability of E2 is nothing but 80%, 80 by 100. From this we get contradiction, means it's not telling truth, means lie. 1 minus P of E1 is nothing but 25 by 100, and also P of E2 complement is nothing but 1 minus P of E2. What is 1 minus P of E2 is nothing but 20 divided by 100. No way to speak A and B or contradict to each other means, suppose E1 speaks the truth, but at a time B speaks lie. This is one possibility. E2 speaks truth, but at a time E1 speaks lie. At least one must be happen. There are two possibilities. Both must be happen. Contradict to each other means both are giving the speaking the same statement in opposite way. At least one must be happen means, what is that? In between that we are going to take union. The probability of at least one must be happen. Suppose this is happen, you can't expect another one. Therefore, both the cases are mutually exclusive. Therefore, from the addition theorem, what we get? Probability of E1 intersection E2 complement plus probability of E1 complement intersection E2 from the addition theorem, but both are mutually exclusive. Now, the next is, I go for multiplication theorem. Speaking a truth or lie for person A, person B, different. That their behavior, that's all. What we speak the truth or lie for A is not reflects to the B. We take generally, don't take a particular case. Generally, it depends upon his nature, the particular person nature. Therefore, even E2 are independent. Even E2 are independent. Therefore, the corresponding complement also independent. It's already discussed in the last class. The complement also independent. Okay. Therefore, from the multiplication theorem, this can be written as probability of E1 into probability of E2 probability of E1 into probability of E2 plus probability of E2 complement, sorry, probability of E1 complement into probability of E2. Okay, fine. Now I have to substitute the value. Already known this, I have written the board. What's the value? Now I have to substitute P of E1 is 75 by 100, P of E2 complement. This is from this theorem, multiplication theorem. Okay, fine. Now this is probability of E1 complement. Okay, this is nothing but 20 divided by 100 plus 25 divided by 100 into 80 divided by 100. Yeah, simplify that. Finally, we get the answer for this is 7 by 20. Don't expect it. Do it on the board simplification. Now, observe carefully here. I told in the beginning of second class of the probability, sometimes you are using addition theorem, sometimes you are using multiplication theorem, sometimes you are using both. In this problem, we are used both addition and multiplication theorem. I think it's clear what's the use, what you study for multiplication theorem and addition theorem. With the help of addition and multiplication theorem, easy to find out. Otherwise, you find the probability of this case is very tedious, very lengthy. It's not easy to connect favorable number of cases. If you want to overcome, then we have to convert into simple form. There we are using addition and multiplication theorem. While taking addition theorem, observe whether the events are mutually exclusive or not. While taking multiplication theorem, observe whether events are independent or not. Okay, I think it's clear. I covered all different type of problems in my lecture. You refer my rest of the problem. I'm going to share it in my e-contact notes. You go through it. At the end of the video, definitely I'm sharing my email ID. If you have any doubt, you're free to contact through email. Okay. Thank you very much. Bye. See you and take care. In the next class, I'm going to discuss Bayes' theorem. Bayes' theorem I'm going to explain. Based on that, we are going to solve the problem. That's the last topic for module 5. Bye. See you and take care.